So there is no better friend on Capitol Hill than Senator Ed Markey. Senator, thank you for joining us.
Today, climate change is a huge threat. The planet is dangerously warming. There are no emergency rooms for planets. And so what we have in the room is the solution to this incredible threat.
Yeah.
And the changes that are taking place are massive and revolutionary. They are things that no one thought was possible. The experts said it cannot happen. All of those people who look at technological breakthroughs say ultimately solar and wind and biofuels and low-end hydro, all of this combined will just be a minuscule part of the solution to climate change. But what has happened? What has happened is that up to the end of last year, 20,000 megawatts of solar was installed in the United States. In 2015 and 2016 combined, 20,000 megawatts of solar is going to be installed in the United States, doubling the total capacity to 40,000 just in 2 years in the United States of America. In China, they too have lifted their sights to what is possible. In wind, we have 65,000 megawatts of wind installed in the United States as of the end of 2014. 90% of it installed just since 2005. What is going to happen in our country in 2015 and 2016? We're going to see 17,000 to 18,000 new megawatts of wind installed in the United States of America, leading us by the end of 2016 with 120,000 megawatts of wind and solar in our country. That doesn't count hydro, that doesn't count biofuels, that doesn't count combined cycle revolutions that are taking place in our country and around the world as well. Half of all new electricity installed in the world last year was renewables. This is the revolution that the experts never saw coming. And they never saw it coming because they didn't understand how resolute the people in this room were going to be, how ardent their desire to be a part of this great revolution, which is taking place in our country, leading to the rest of the world. And what makes it possible is good policies that are put on the books at the state and the federal level. The tax breaks for wind, the tax breaks for solar, the tax breaks which continue to expire for wind, which always leads to about a 70% decline in the amount of wind the next year. That must end. We must extend the tax break for wind in our country. With solar, those tax breaks expire at the end of next year. We have to make sure that this revolution continues because there is a Moore's Law for wind and for solar in the same way that there is for technology. Every time there is a global doubling of the deployment of solar, there's an 18% drop in the price of solar. This is the Moore's Law of solar. If we keep it in place, the same experts, doubters of this generation, will join the ranks of those that never saw the Wright brothers reinventing the way in which we move around this country. And it happened in the blink of an eye. Those that never saw Henry Ford going from producing 9,000 Model Ts in 2009 to producing 2 million Model Ts in 1923. 1909-1923. Yes. Clear that. Elon Musk, Solar City. What do they say? We're going to produce an all-electric vehicle that gets 35 miles, they cost $35,000. We're going to have Solar City install the battery pack with solar panels so that those homes can produce all renewable energy. The payback time will just be 3 or 4 years because of this increased efficiency. And we're going to see a revolution like we saw with Henry Ford from 1909 to 1923. We're going to see things that no one ever saw coming. That's happening. And it's happening because on each one of these issues, there's one thing that separates us from the experts. They are wrong and we are right. Okay? And so when you look at all of these people who are doing the analysis, and they continue to project the gains as though they're incremental and not geometric, they do not understand what is happening. And so yes, what Elon Musk is doing today is what the Wright brothers did, is what Henry Ford did. They're reinventing industries. And we can do it, but we have to stay active. You have to stay aggressive. You have to stay in this game. You have to insist that the United States Congress extends the wind tax break and extends the solar tax break. You have to insist on this. And you have to insist that the policies that deal with low-head hydro, with biomass, the biofuels,
geothermal,
stays in place. Power Africa is helping over in Ethiopia with a project that could lead to a 1,000 megawatt geothermal project in Ethiopia. Think about that. That revolutionizes an economy for an entire part of a country in Africa. We should be the leaders. We should be showing on each one of these issues that it can be done. We are a country that says we can do it. We are a country that has been the leader in innovation for 200 years. This is the revolution of our time. And we thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for everything that you are doing. And Scott, thank you for giving me the honor of being here with all of the great friends of the planet. We have.
You can do well, you can do good, you can get rich, and you can save the planet.
Thank you.
Sounds good to me. Thank you. I do want to say, decades ago, when many of us in this room were being ridiculed, we would go to this man and he would just be saying, you're not bullish enough. And he would like be the only one up here to do it.